Welcome to the SISEP video on implementation drivers. Behind every effort to implement an evidence-based practice are infrastructure, activities, and supports that drive implementation forward. Implementation drivers are split into competency drivers, which build the knowledge, skills, and abilities of implementers, and organization drivers that create a system that is conducive to using practices and programs as intended. Leadership is the foundation that supports or enables the work of drivers. When leaders create opportunities for choosing practices that meet the needs of their students or community, support practitioners to implement the evidence-based practice and programs with fidelity, and are intentional in removing the barriers to successful implementation, student outcomes improve. We will walk through an example of a school leveraging implementation drivers to use a new literacy practice. Mr. Harrison was the principal of Billingsworth Elementary School. District leaders prioritized an initiative to improve literacy outcomes for kindergarten through fifth grade students over the next 5 years. This initiative included training all teachers on the science of reading and coaching teachers to use in evidence-based literacy practices. Mr. Harrison was both excited and nervous. He knew only about 40% of his students at his school were consistently reading at proficient levels. He also knew his teachers would need intentional support to shift learning from theory to the classroom. Luckily, Mr. Harrison already had an implementation team at a school, and with his leadership, they were ready. Mr. Harrison and the team began by planning to support capacity building in the school using the competency drivers as a guide. Starting with selection, the team revisited their hiring processes. Mr. Harrison had 3 openings for classroom teachers for the upcoming school year. The team updated the job description and preferred qualifications to include use of structured literacy and evidence-based practices in literacy following the science of reading. They also had a requirement for all interviewees to teach a literacy lesson using explicit instruction as part of the interview process. By making these changes, Mr. Harrison knew that the new hires would already be aligned to the school's mission. Next, the team focused on planning the professional development. The district offered to pay for professional development on the science of reading through a local university for 2 semesters. The team designed a system for skill-based training that included designating people to be accountable for coordinating the quality and timeliness of the training, ensuring that the trainers from the local university included opportunities in the learning for teachers to practice the new strategies with feedback, and incorporated the use of training data for improvement. Up next was coaching. Each grade level team chose 1 PLC per month to discuss content from their training and practice literacy routines with their literacy facilitator, Ms. Stone. They also had individual coaching sessions during class to strengthen teacher practice. Ms. Stone met with each teacher at least monthly for live support, observations, and feedback between PLCs. Now let's move over to the organization drivers and see how they develop supports to create an enabling context to implement science of reading practices, starting with data. The school used an assessment system aligned to the science of reading that measured phonemic awareness, phonics, fluency, vocabulary, and comprehension skills. They conducted universal screenings 3 times per year and progress monitored students who needed more support. Grade levels discussed student data during PLC meetings once a month and used that data to make instructional decisions. The implementation team reviewed student impact data in addition to how the practices were being implemented. Fidelity data, as well as data from teacher surveys asking about any barriers and feasibility, was used along with student data to continuously improve selection, training, and coaching processes and break down barriers to using the reading practices effectively. Let's take a look at how Mr. Harrison removed barriers through facilitative administration. Mr. Harrison developed communication feedback loops between his teachers and the implementation team. Each grade level PLC met with Ms. Stone at least monthly. The teachers expressed a concern about how infrequently they could meet with Ms. Stone because she had so many teachers to support. They suggested partnering with each other for peer coaching during weeks Ms. Stone was with another grade level. Ms. Stone shared this with Mr. Harrison. The implementation team worked out the logistics, and each interested teacher paired up with a peer for support during the weeks Ms. Stone was unavailable. Now we'll see how the team reached out for support through systems intervention. Mr. Harrison did not have the money in the current budget for hiring another coach to team up with Ms. Stone. The team asked Ms. Stone to reach out to the university providing the PD to inquire about including coaching support. Even though they were unable to provide that level of support right away, the university team began planning to add a coaching option for the upcoming semester. How does Fidelity fit into the story? Mr. Harrison, Ms. Stone, and the team met once a month to discuss fidelity of teacher practice. Ms. Stone used aggregated data by grade level to avoid observations being considered evaluative. Instead, they used a checklist for explicit instruction and reading. With the goal of teachers using practices as intended, the team used fidelity data to identify concepts and skills that were more difficult than others and provide extra support to grade levels needing that support. Fidelity is a driver and outcome of effective implementation. When active implementation is occurring with fidelity, teachers are more likely to reach fidelity of instruction. When teachers are meeting fidelity of instruction, student outcomes are more likely to change. Finally, leadership plays a critical role in supporting active implementation. Mr. Harrison was a strong leader who understood the importance of active implementation. He relied on a team. They built multi-directional communication pathways. They created plans, followed through, analyzed results, and made adjustments when needed. He cared about buy-in and supporting teachers. Through his leadership, his teachers were on the right path to strengthening literacy practices and improving student literacy outcomes. The final key feature of implementation drivers is their integrated and compensatory nature. All drivers are integrated and aligned with the new practices and compensate with each other when one is lacking. Implementation drivers are an essential component of effective implementation. By attending to processes to strengthen staff competency and organizing the system to create a hospitable environment, schools are more likely to adopt new practices, maintain them over time, and improve student outcomes.